speaking. And that was going all right until about 2 months ago for work. I had to do like a safety speech to about 50 people. And I had a meltdown, and my legs started shaking so much that one of my colleagues afterwards came and asked if I'd been possessed by Elvis. So, so I got back from work up in Northwest Australia. I got back and I went and saw a hypnotherapist. He's I paid him about like $400. He's put some things into my head to calm me down and sort of get through that. And it's also suggested I should come and do stand up comedy as a way of getting over the fear of public speaking. And I said, well, that's all right, but I don't know anything about stand up comedy. And he said, don't worry, I'll write your set for you. So here's the set. Hi, has anyone here got any kids?
Yeah.
Well, I have two of twins, 13 year olds, nightmares. Well, at least one of them is, not sure which one, as they look the same. But they don't. Well, he's there. The other one doesn't look anything like him. I told him that. And he was listening. Anyway, one's great. We'll say that you're the great one. And the other one, who's at home, is just a smart ass. And he's actually at home. He didn't want to come. I said, do you want to come and watch me? He said, no, Dad, but it's all right, because if you're really shit, I'll still love you anyway. Anyway, so I call them the things, as you do. Thing one and thing two. Now, I've done this three times, and I think it's a Cat and Hat reference, but I'm not too sure. So, the other day, I'm arguing with thing one, at least I think it was thing one, could have been thing two. Like I said, they look the same. But for argument's sake, let's say it was thing one. And I use the old, and maybe one day you have kids of your own. And he replied, he looked at me and he replied, he said, and maybe someday so will you. Exactly. So, and he's written a little footnote here, and it says, if no one laughs at the joke or thinks it's funny, Peter, just pull out the clapper, that's this. This will create an environment for applause, which works really well for Mariah Carey and the NBL. So, back to the joke. So what was that supposed to mean? Was my wife having an affair? And I thought about asking her, but then I thought, maybe not. So I took his brother, thing two, out for a walk to see if I could find out what thing one had meant by what he'd said. Thing two was a real nice kid. One of those real sweet, innocent types. You know, the type that wouldn't hurt a fly. So we're out walking, and thing two points out at a dead bird lying on the ground on his back with his feet sticking straight up in the air. Thing two says to me, hey Dad, why is that bird lying on the ground with its legs sticking straight up in the air? And I look at the bird, and then I look at this cute little guy, and I reply to him, well, thing two, that's because he's dead, and his legs are sticking up in the air like that as a sign to God to come and take him away. And thing two looked up at me, and he had a tear in his eye, and he said, oh my God, Dad, the other day we nearly lost Mum. Well, you can imagine my reaction. I'm like, what do you mean, thing two? And he replied, yeah, the other day I was walking past her room and she was lying on the bed with her feet in the air yelling, God, I'm coming. And if it wasn't for the Foxtel guy holding her down, we would have lost her for sure. Well, I paid $400 for that. Anyway, that's about the best joke that I've had. What else has he got here? Yeah, I'm starting to think my hypnotherapist is a cop. Bam! 3 times. But you can't believe in yourself. It's only 4. Alright, well, I think that was a bit of a jihad attack on my own self-esteem, so I'm not believing it. No worries.